Ve, entonces nos vemos en el puente Ortiz. Ok.
Excusez-moi, monsieur. Savez-vous où se trouve l'église La Ermita?
Disculpe, señor, ¿sabe dónde está la iglesia de la ermita?
Parlez au microphone, s'il vous plaît.
Hable por el micrófono, por favor.
Buenos días. Sí, señor, la iglesia se encuentra a 100 metros a la derecha. Merci beaucoup. Bonne journée.
Muchas gracias. Buen día.
De nada, feliz día.
De rien. Bonne journée.
How you doing, everyone? So here is the second video in the series on apps for learning languages. As promised, in today's episode, we're going to explore the conversation and transcribe features of Google Translate. At the end of the video, I will share a few tips on using the app in general, so stay tuned. As pointed out in the previous video, AI has advanced tremendously in the last decades and will continue to do so. In my opinion, however, the features I will show you today will never replace the intercultural experience of learning a language. Having made this caveat, let's go to the steps on using the conversation and transcribe features of Google Translate. Open the Translate app and under the writing space, choose the conversation option. Choose the input and output languages that will be used by the speakers in the conversation. Step 3 has two options. Option 1 is tapping the microphone option and orally say the sentences or phrases intended to communicate. After one person says something and the app has made the oral translation, tap the microphone option on the side of the other speaker and repeat the process. Option 2 only requires to tap the microphone icon in the middle for both speakers. Both speakers can take turns to orally say the phrases or sentences wanted to communicate. You now know how to use the conversation feature of Google Translate. The transcribe feature will help you transcribe audios by just playing the recordings or by speaking to the app and letting it do its job. Simply open the Translate app and choose the input and output languages. Select the transcribe option under the writing space and start speaking or playing the audio or video recording, making sure you place the phone in a good distance to the device so it gets a clear sound. The transcription will start automatically as the recording is being played or as you speak. Check out the next example. All right, so I'm gonna show you how the app actually works by playing a video in French, and here I have another camera that will show how it does it in the phone. All right.
Salut, merci de me rejoindre pour cette nouvelle vidéo. On va parler d'un sujet bien qui revient souvent dans les discussions que j'ai avec les membres de la famille de Français Authentique, qui est le vocabulaire. L'apprentissage du vocabulaire et surtout le fait de ne rien oublier. Avant ça, je voulais t'indiquer que du 5 au 11 juillet, il y avait une promotion sur tous les cours de français authentique. C'est même valable sur le cours 30 jours pour booster ton français.
All right, so I'm gonna stop it now, and you will see on one side of the screen the work that the app did. All right, so that was the example. Alright, so we reached the final part of the episode in which I share some general tips on how to use the Translate in a conventional way. Make sure you capitalize proper nouns so they don't get translated when typed in the app. Make good use of punctuation marks. A comma, a period, a semicolon could make a difference in the meaning. Don't divide lines by hitting enter. This will also affect meaning. If you copy a text and the lines are divided by default, make sure you reorganize the text before translating it. And the last tip is learn to use your language first before you jump to translate to a different language or from another language. Remember to check proper spelling, grammar rules, and differences between the languages to translate. And surely enough, you will have a better outcome. Alright guys, so we reached the end of this episode. If you did it this far, thank you very much. Don't forget to hit that like button, leave your comments, your questions in the comment section right below, and subscribe if you haven't done so. Alright, so I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye, take care.